Everyone has heard the arguments against space travel, especially manned space travel. Shouldn't we be concentrating on our Earth, solving our own problems before setting off to distant worlds? Shouldn't we therefore invest all our resources and drive in more meaningful projects? Most people think of eliminating hunger, defeating diseases, or improving the global education system. All laudable and worthwhile goals, yet reality shows us that hundreds of billions of euros are not spent on them, but elsewhere. Even decades after the end of the Cold War, arms spending has not been cut back. Instead, new enemies have been sought and global defense spending is climbing to new heights year after year and has long since exceeded the trillion euro mark. Spaceflight, like all basic research, is initially costly and requires large budgets. However, this money is not burned in the combustion chamber of a rocket, but flows into the economic cycle. At first glance, the benefits of space travel appear to be limited for the vast majority of people. But a somewhat deeper look reveals that space travel has significantly improved our lives and even helps us solve the problems mentioned earlier. Thanks to space travel, we now know more about our planet than ever before. Numerous satellites orbit our planet and continuously provide us with data about the weather, ocean currents, and climate changes. Even forest fires in less densely populated areas are detected by satellites these days. Only on the basis of this data do we know about climate change and that it will, in particular, exacerbate the problem of hunger and thus cause streams of refugees, as whole regions of the Earth will be uninhabitable in the future. Furthermore, satellite data shows us the population growth of cities and thus provides information about the spread of slums faster and more accurately than would otherwise be possible. Without this information, it would be difficult to determine the necessary water and electricity requirements in advance, and it would also not be possible to coordinate public transport with this. We also take satellite television for granted, including reporters who can report to us live from the world's hotspots, which would not be possible without satellites. Before Telstar, the first satellite for intercontinental data transmission, information had to be transmitted using deep-sea cables or radio waves. We've also become accustomed to entering our destination into the GPS navigation system rather than reading roadmaps in the car. Even during a flight, we rely on being able to surf the internet and use social media. But this would not take place without satellites, as modern passenger planes would not be able to find their way in the sky without satellite navigation in today's air traffic volume. In the future, we'll go a step further and, among other things, coordinate rescue operations in the event of natural disasters from orbit, using satellites to send live images to Earth. Thanks to satellites, several billion people in developing countries will soon have widespread access to the internet for the first time. There are many other reasons to pursue space travel, but even if all these reasons cannot convince someone, there's one factor that can be relied upon: human greed. There are gigantic deposits of raw materials full of precious metals waiting in the asteroid belt, on the Moon and Mars, and sooner or later they will be mined. The innovative power and benefits of space travel. Breakthrough technology such as the steam engine, which enabled the Industrial Revolution and the development of locomotives, the airplane, and the transistor, often triggered a cascade of secondary inventions. Innovations and technological breakthroughs do not come out of anywhere, nor can any money buy them. Sometimes, they even arise only as a waste product. When John F. Kennedy gave his inspirational speech and stated the moon as a goal, the USA had just twice gained 15 minutes of experience with manned space flights and was clearly behind the Soviet Union in the space race. A rocket that could have reached the moon, a lunar spaceship, and even docking maneuvers in space were mere dreams of the future at that time. Nevertheless, the US succeeded in sending humans to the Earth satellite within 9 years. This was a tremendous feat of strength for an entire nation. Many of today's inventions, such as compact computer technology, the cordless drill, the fuel cell, and solar technology, can be traced back to the Apollo program or have become known to a larger public through this project. In addition, numerous companies and people were forced to organize and coordinate, which is why the manned moon landing helped project management achieve a worldwide breakthrough. The manned moon landing inspired many young people to become interested in technology. When the American flag was raised on the moon for the first time, it was a symbol for all mankind. It showed what is possible when many people work together and are motivated. A symbol of progress and teamwork, of perseverance and flexibility, of the performance of a society with a clear goal in mind. The fact that the moon landing also made economic sense and not only covered its costs should only be mentioned in passing. However, it should be mentioned that many space enthusiasts had hoped that a trip to Mars would be made after the successful moon landing. These hopes were quickly dashed as, with the end of the Apollo program, spaceflight entered a new phase with much lower budgets and less ambitious goals. Instead of a manned mission to Mars, the focus for the next few decades was on near-Earth space. Here, the topic of international understanding also played a major role. In 1975, there was the aforementioned Apollo-Soyuz project, which, in the middle of the Cold War, led to an American-Soviet rendezvous in space. In addition, the exploration of other planets also helped us learn something about our Earth. For example, the threat to Earth's ozone layer from chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs, was discovered when scientists, with NASA's support, studied the frequency of chemical reactions of chlorine and other halogens in Venus's atmosphere. Spaceflight is also the driving force behind light weighting and energy efficiency. Every kilogram launched into space still incurs enormous costs, and a planetary probe, once launched, must function for several years without maintenance. Every gram of weight and every watt of electrical power matters. A major benefit is space medicine, and it's literally saving lives. For example, several new sensors and technologies have been developed to monitor the health of an astronaut aboard a space station. Today's wearables, such as fitness bracelets, have their origins in this. Even modern smoke detectors trace their origins to the Skylab program, since fire is a serious hazard aboard a space station. In addition, the treatment of water is essential for life on a space station, which is why drinking water filters can also be tracked back to this. NASA also invested in the development of shock-absorbing and comfortable materials for artificial limbs for robots, but this also helps humans and animals who rely on prosthetic limbs. Another spin-off, or byproduct if you wish, of space exploration is further support for archaeology. Aerial photography has long helped draw archaeologists' attention to areas of interest that they would otherwise miss. For some years now, archaeologists have been receiving support even from space. Moreover, the origins of digital photography also lie in space travel, as a system had to be developed to immediately process captured satellite images. A question of survival. Any non-spacefaring civilization is not only at risk of extinction, but will actually die out sooner or later. There have been a number of mass extinctions in Earth's history, as we've already shown in a separate video. On several occasions, scientists such as Mikio Kaku have suggested that humanity must become a species on two planets. In addition to a variety of terrestrial dangers, such as the eruption of a supervolcano, a global ice age, or a pandemic, there are also external sources of danger to life on Earth. The danger, which comes from asteroid or comet impacts, is not to be underestimated, and curiously, it is our warlike nature that gives us the possibility to protect ourselves against this. A less aggressive species might never have developed missiles and warheads with a nuclear response, and therefore would have little chance in deflecting an asteroid on a collision course. Cosmic projectiles have struck Earth many times in the past, dealing a setback or two to terrestrial life. The last time a larger chunk hit Earth was in Siberia in 1908. In this so-called Tunguska event, there was not only a strange glow over Europe and Asia, so that one could still read the newspaper in London at night, but also dozens of square kilometers of forest area were devastated. In addition, our sun could become dangerous to us. In 1989, for example, a solar storm flattened large parts of the Canadian power grid in the so-called Quebec blackout. Even before that, in August 1859, we were hit by a solar storm of the century, which today would have devastating consequences in view of the complex technology in our power supply and telecommunications, but at that time only caused the telegraph lines to glow and sporadic fires. Furthermore, there is much more energy-intensive radiation, which is released in a supernova explosion or a gamma-ray burst, which could abruptly extinguish life on Earth if it occurs in the cosmic neighborhood. In order to ensure the survival of mankind, other celestial bodies must necessarily be colonized. Because if there should be a global catastrophe on Earth, all traces of human activity on Earth would have disappeared within a few centuries due to the chemical and biological degradation reactions. Only on the moon will the human legacies of the Apollo program and the other lunar missions still be visible millennia from now. Five of the six flags erected during the lunar landings are still standing today, as images from the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, LRO, show. It's assumed that the flag from Apollo 11 fell over during the lunar module launch. Even if the flags are faded by solar radiation in the meantime, the footprints of the astronauts are still visible today. However, technological progress itself also poses a danger. Indeed, the most dangerous for civilization is the transitions, as, for example, the entry into the nuclear age has shown. A warlike nature coupled with the technical knowledge of how to make weapons of mass destruction is dangerous. This is because weapons of mass destruction can cause damage and consequences to occur globally. The biggest problem here is that moral and ethical behavior is not evolving as fast as technology. No matter how hard we try, within the next billion years, it will become uncomfortable. For one thing, the moon is moving away from the Earth by about 3.78 centimeters per year, which will cause its rotation to become more unstable in the long run. In addition, the Earth will lose its oxygen within 1 billion years, and then, still, the Sun will inflate within the next 5 billion years to a red giant, and will swallow the inner planets of our solar system. But already before that, the Earth will become uninhabitable for mankind because stars will become hotter and hotter with increasing age, and the water on Earth will evaporate. So, not only the technical probes which have already left the solar system, but also the culture and the knowledge of the whole of mankind are preserved. A larger expenditure is necessary. Therefore, it's not enough to spread only in the solar system, but mankind must become a nation of star travelers.